Another PlayStation 4 exclusive has made its way to PC, Horizon Zero Dawn. It may be a little over 3 years old at this point, but I was pretty hyped to replay one of 2017's standout games with cranked up visuals, higher frame rates, and keyboard and mouse controls. Unfortunately, it's come with some very mixed results in my experience. Horizon Zero Dawn is visually captivating. Its wilderness is rich with thick vegetation, vast mountain ranges, and sweeping deserts. Remnants of the world's high-tech past with imposing, beastly machines contrast with the natural environments in a fascinating way that entices you to uncover more of the story's mysteries. That's all part of why a PC version is a pretty big deal. But even with the launch day patch that's supposed to help with stability, performance hiccups, and some graphical shortcomings can overshadow these elements. I used a rig equipped with a Core i7-7700K, RTX 2080, 16GB of RAM, and a Samsung 970 Pro NVMe SSD. It's a fairly high-end system. I also used an ultra-wide resolution of 2560 by 1080, which is 21:9, and set all graphical options to their maximum along with temporal anti-aliasing. While I could maintain around 80 FPS in many open areas, my mileage varied by virtue of the changing density of towns and village, or the intensity of certain chaotic combat encounters. Here, I would experience drastic drops in frame rate to about 35 to 40 FPS. It's expected that a game of this scale and fidelity would be quite graphically demanding, but not necessarily to this degree. And what stands out is the inconsistency in performance, on top of occasional stuttering or hitching throughout my time. The folks at Digital Foundry did a deep dive and came away with some similar performance anomalies across different PC setups as well. Now there are bugs like the anisotropic filtering option just not working, which you can force in your driver's control panel. It's an important graphics setting for a vast open world game as it provides much more clarity for surfaces off in the distance. I also experienced things like textures on character models and surfaces and objects in the world glitching out in various egregious ways. These aren't just minor annoyances either, they're glaring faults. You also want to be sure to update your graphics drivers to the latest versions. Using older versions may result in serious artifacting, which is a mistake I made when first booting up the game, but have fixed that since then. And when you do boot up the game for the first time, expect to sit through a 10 to 15 minute loading screen that loads up shaders. The list of bugs doesn't end at the graphics department, however. There are a few issues that actually hold the game back from working as intended. For example, the concentration ability is supposed to let you zoom in and slow down time to carefully aim your bow. But in my particular experience, activating it only zooms in and does not slow down time at all. This problem extends to other time slowing mechanics, such as pulling up the weapon wheel, and the perk that's supposed to slow things down when aiming while sliding or in mid-air. Everything keeps moving at a normal speed. I tried experimenting with different settings to see if it was an issue tied to unlocked frame rates or VSync, but such is not the case. I even used another PC setup to see if the game could shake off these weird bugs, but it was the same in that situation too. My colleague Jean-Luc, who's actually making this video, experienced the same problems. However, many others have not. Like another colleague, Matt Rory at Giant Bomb, who did the Horizon Zero Dawn PC quick look. These time-slowing mechanics are integral to the game, and extremely useful for all the game's combat situations, and the fact that they may not function properly is a major problem. Now, aside from the aforementioned issues, this PC port offers some welcome features, such as an FOV slider, native ultra-wide support, fully customizable control mappings, an uncapped frame rate, and a benchmarking tool to test out the viability of your chosen graphics settings. As for the game itself, Horizon Zero Dawn impressed back in 2017 as the first open-world effort from Killzone developer Guerrilla Games. While there's a noticeable reliance on a few tired open-world gameplay tropes, it stood out with an excellent combat system that emphasized precise aiming, exploiting weaknesses, and clever use of the many neat weapons and tools in your loadout. Horizon has a distinct David and Goliath type feel, as you're often overwhelmed by massive, hostile machines and seemingly ill-equipped. Like, how the hell am I supposed to destroy robot dinosaurs with a bow and arrow? Devising ways to overcome these odds has a satisfying feel, especially in big fights that test your mastery of the makeshift arsenal. Horizon's style of combat always left me wanting to use keyboard and mouse, given the need to land pinpoint shots, but that comes with some concessions. The nature of using WASD to move in this style of third-person action isn't as intuitive as an analog stick, and the need to dodge roll or platform in high-pressure situations highlights how exact directional movement can be awkward. And with the concentration ability broken for me, I haven't really been able to wield mouse aiming the way I expected either. It's also worth noting that controllers have native support, with proper button mappings and all, if you prefer. What remains intact is Horizon's narrative ambitions. A 31st century where civilizations are thriving as hunters and gatherers is fascinating, as it's juxtaposed to a quote-unquote old world of futurist tech buried in the waste of a calamity from long ago. Our protagonist Aloy remains steadfast in the wake of wild revelations about her past and the truths about how a super advanced civilization continues to haunt the present day from its grave mistakes and the technology it left behind. These are also really good excuses to have robot dinosaurs roam the wilderness and pose major threats to you, since it does come together in a thematically coherent fashion. But overall, it's quite disappointing to see the game in a rough state, even with day one fixes. Considering that Horizon was the progenitor for Guerrilla's Decima engine, and we just saw Death Stranding hit PC with an outstanding port which uses the same engine, I'm also surprised by its shortcomings. If you're in the mood for a sprawling open world with some top-notch combat thrills that sometimes get bogged down in genre routines, there's a great game underneath. But be aware that lacking performance and game-affecting bugs may come with the territory.